In this video, I'm going to show you one of the coolest applications that I've built using Bolt. It is an AI-powered to-do list app that automatically categorizes your to-dos and helps you prioritize them automatically. And there's also natural language processing, so it automatically can schedule tasks based on how you write it. This app uses OpenAI as the AI component. And then I used Bolt to completely build the app and design it. I'm going to show you what is possible in Bolt. I think you're going to be really impressed by what this app can do. I'm going to talk through some of the challenges that I had building it. So if you're building an app like this as well, you can hopefully avoid some of the issues that I had. And then also talk about some of the things I'm thinking about to build in the future. So let me give you a quick demo of what I built using Bolt. So here we have the today field, so you can see any task that is due today. You can also see the different projects. You can create different projects, and then you can have sub-projects within the project. And the AI itself will actually create these sub-projects, or it'll put your task into an existing sub-project if it fits. So it's automatically going to help you categorize your tasks as you create them. So just as an example, let's say I want to add a new task, and let's make it really simple. First, I'm going to say go to the gym tomorrow. So if I say go to the gym tomorrow, it's going to analyze that task. And then it's going to put it into personal. And then it also created a new subcategory called fitness schedule. And then it set it for tomorrow. So let's say I want to add a new task, which is clean the kitchen today. And also, by putting it today, it should automatically, here we go, put it into personal. Now put it into home cleaning. And then it automatically put it into the today. Also here, now we can see up in today, our task is set, which is pretty cool. So that's just a quick example of kind of how that works. Now let's do another one, which is, let's say I want to create YouTube thumbnails. And let's say I want to do this every Thursday. So what I'm going to do is enter. It's going to analyze the task. Hopefully, it'll put it into our existing subcategory. So you saw on the other tasks, it created new subcategories. But let's see if it puts it into our existing. Okay, cool. So it did. It put it into the YouTube video category that we already had under No Code MBA. It put it at as today, even though I said every Thursday and today is Wednesday. So I'd have to look into that, but and then it has weekly set automatically as well, which is pretty cool. So now I guess because that was today, now they're both showing up as today. Another thing I built in is the ability to change the order. This and you can also click in and edit the details of the task. Doing the dragging was a little bit tricky. I can do the same thing on the projects and change the order of them. But yeah, doing this was a little bit tricky with the dragging and dropping. Something I would recommend is if you are building in Bolt and you have a feature that just isn't working, I would recommend saying, the current way that you're building this isn't working. Can you try a different library to see if that will work? So essentially, it's using a library to add this functionality into your apps. So if you say, please, use a different library, that's what I did. And then it used a different one that where the dragging and dropping did actually work. So that's something to keep in mind. If you check them off, we've got these nice animations and then they go here underneath. Doing the animation was also a little bit tricky. That took a lot of back and forth of just getting it so that it looked nice. And I think that there's still, I could bring it to the next level. But overall, I'm pretty happy with how it looks now, but that's something where it kind of just took a lot of back and forth. Something else to keep in mind. So this app is hooked up to Supabase. Check out our other video on our channel. where we explained how to connect Bolt to Supabase. And I think in the future, Bolt is going to make it actually even easier to connect to Supabase. But something to keep in mind when you're building an app is, let's say you're building a feature, you update your Supabase database, and then you want to go back and remove the feature or change it. Something to keep in mind is if you have already changed your database and you're changing the feature or you're removing that feature, the database is going to stay the same because basically any updates you make here in Bolt aren't going to necessarily change your database that is in Supabase. So if you do that, you have to say, hey, something that I did was say, hey, I've changed the database. I want to have a SQL query that will delete the full database and create new tables that match with the current app. So that's something that I did that I would recommend you doing as well if you're in that situation. So it can be really helpful. Future features that I'm thinking about is having like a daily email that can look at all of the tasks and kind of use AI to kind of email you maybe a plan based on the tasks that you have set up. I'm also curious about potentially integrating with like a calendar or email or things like that to help bring tasks in. And then other AI features to maybe help break down the tasks, or if it's a task that, you know, it could maybe do or do a first draft of, that could be interesting. So if it's like I need to write an email then about a specific topic, maybe the AI could do that or help you get started. So I'm just these are just ideas that I'm kind of thinking about. But let me know what you think. I think this is one of the cooler apps that I've seen built on Bolt. So hopefully you like it as well. Check the link in the description to join the waitlist for our prompt to product Bolt community, Bolt and Lovable community for building apps using AI coding. If you're interested in that and you want to take this to the next level with a community of other people all with the same goals, check the link in the description or the comments. Or go to No Code MBA to learn more about building with AI and No Code to check out all of the in-depth tutorials that we have there about building with tools like Bubble and Airtable and Zapier and Webflow and all of these No Code and AI tools that help you build on the internet without needing to know how to code. So, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. Leave a comment if you have any questions about this, and I'll see you in the next video.